Hey everyone, I hope you had a great day. In this video, we are looking at some new R/Entitled Parent stories. I hope you enjoy them. The first story is called, That's Not a Dog Name. I live in Argentina. I'm an advanced student in English teaching. I have four dogs and one of them is named Monkey. Before lockdown was enforced and made mandatory back in March, I used to tutor this kid in English. He would be studying English classes at school this year, and his mom had wanted him to have a head start in comparison to the other kids in his class. She said that her kid was insecure about starting school and wanted him to feel accomplished and smart by being ahead of his classmates. Weird logic, but okay. She was paying me good money, and the kid actually showed an interest in the language and all the activities I did with him. So tutoring him was actually enjoyable for both of us. When the lockdown was enforced, we had to suspend the tutoring sessions because public transport was unavailable and they lived in the other corner of the city. Fast forward to today. I took my dog Monkey for a walk today and we ran into the entitled mother and her kid at the park. The kid was thrilled to meet one of my dogs at last. I had talked to him about them before and showed him pics. He was very polite and asked what her name was, how old she was, if he could pet her and so on. When I told him that my dog's name was Monkey, he was thrilled to let me know that he knew what that word meant because they had learned about different animals in his classes during the year. The entitled mother was less thrilled to know that I had named my dog as another animal. She started questioning me, although it felt more like an interrogation about why I would do that, if I did it just to show off my skills in English, if I was aware it could be confusing, and so on. I asked her what she meant by confusing, thinking that she meant by the gender of my dog. I find it silly that people assume an animal's gender by their names, but it happens. But she said, why would you try to confuse my son by naming a dog as another animal? He's trying hard to learn things in English because you prompted him to. And now, whenever he hears the word monkey, he will think of your dog. I tried to explain to her why I had chosen that name for my dog. But she then went on about how I should change my dog's name to something more dog-like, so children like her son wouldn't feel confused about animals. She was very insistent on names I should call my dog, even telling her son to try calling Monkey other names to see if she responded. I almost told her I could probably call her the mother's name instead, because she's a witch. After all, no confusion there. But I restrained, because the kid was there, and I didn't want to deal with her getting all angry at me in public. The kid said he liked Monkey's name, because it's unique and suits her because of her curly tail, like a cartoon monkey. And I told him it was actually one of the reasons I had chosen that name for her. The entitled mother realized there was no win for her in the issue and quickly said some greeting, took her kid and left. Monkey and I actually shared a look for a moment, and I took it as a cue to go home already. The next story is called, Give Him Your Toys. I do my laundry weekly at the exact same laundromat I have for the last year, on the same day of the week, at the same time. Nothing ever happened before, that is, until today. I get into the building, and I notice a mom and her kid, probably no older than 5 or 6, just running around without care. I find an open wash and toss my clothes inside, grab my bag of Tide Pods and toss some in the machine. That's when the kid notices what I have and comes up to me. What are those? They are Tide Pods, they clean my clothes. No they don't, mommy has a big bottle of soap. These are soap too, but they don't make a mess. Oh, okay. The kid runs off to his entitled mother and I assume he is telling her all about Tide Pods. I notice out of the corner of my eye that the entitled mother gestures towards me and says something to the entitled kid. A few moments later the kid is back but doesn't say anything to me. I take out my earbud and ask, what's up? The kid just stares at me and then stares at the bag of pots. I then hear his entitled mother yell from across the room. Well, did you get your toy? I was confused, but the kid just turns tail and runs off back to the mother. I can see that she is telling her kid something, and a few moments later he is back. Can I have some of those? No, they aren't for kids to mess with. But mommy said I could have some to play with. No, you can't. They aren't toys and they aren't yours. But mommy said you have to give me some. I don't care what your mommy said, they aren't yours and they aren't toys. I admit, I started to get heated and my tone of voice started to get more stern. That's when I hear it, the inevitable rumble of an entitled mother. This is a super fun conversation that follows. Excuse me, don't you dare yell at my son. I didn't yell at him, ma'am, I was just, She cuts me off. Don't you lie to me. I hear the whole thing, and you yelled at my baby. Whatever you say, lady. I stop being polite at this point. Mommy, you won't give me the toy. Kid, these aren't toys. She cuts me off again. Give him the toys, now. You are too old to be playing with toys. I'm a 30-year-old man. He deserves them for being such a good boy today. Lady, these are not toys. They are Tide Pods. I don't care what they are. My baby wants to play with them and you have to give them to him. No, I don't. She now looks like she's about to turn into a cartoon dream whistle at this point. So I decided to put my music back on and ignore her. I could hear her very faint yelling over my music. But I just ignored her and she walked away with her wailing child. Now here is where this gets funny and kind of alarming. About half an hour later, I notice that my clothes are done drying and I go over to grab my wonderfully warm clothes from the dryer. That's when I glanced up and noticed the entitled kid wasn't with his entitled mother. I figured he was harassing someone else and didn't think much of it. As I'm folding my laundry, I glance up again and there it was. The kid has my bag of Tide Pods next to his mother and is playing with the pods. And he is being super aggressive with them. Clenching them hard, pulling them from both ends, stomping on them and throwing them around. His entitled mother is sitting there smiling while watching her kid play with a toxic ball of liquid. I immediately walk over and snatch it back from them. What the hell, lady? You let your kid steal from me and playing with something that is toxic? He's fine, it's not like you need them all to yourself. Stop being so selfish. Look, lady, I should call the cops and tell them your kid is running around stealing from people while you let him and that you are letting him play with toxic things like they are toys. You wouldn't dare. He is just a kid. He didn't do anything wrong. And that is when it happened. The kid had jumped onto a Tide Pod and it burst as the kid slipped and hit his head. He's fine, don't worry. The kid started screaming as loud as he could. Look what you did. You hurt my baby. I'm calling the cops. I was a little startled and trying not to laugh out of nervousness for the kid's head hitting the floor. Lady, you call whoever you want. Your kid did this to himself. She just picked up her now snot and soap covered crying kid and left, still screaming about police and how I hurt her kid. I just went back to folding my clothes and left. Police never came while I was there, but the mother left her clothes in the washer. I don't know if she came back for them. Next week I'm going to a different laundromat in another town. The last story is called Karen Sells a House That Is Not Hers. This is a story about entitled people, not entitled parents. This happened in Argentina. Near my house there was an abandoned house. The owner passed away around 2012. I met him, he was a good man, never had children, but he had nephews. After his death, a woman went to live in his house. Nobody said anything, because neighbors used to think that she was his niece, but nope, she isn't. The true nephew went to that house last week and found that Karen is living in the house that his uncle left him. Well, I live like 3 or 4 houses left to her, so I could hear her scream that she bought that house years ago. And that she has all the papers of that house and she is the owner. The truth? Another Karen sold her that house. She works in the town hall and got the papers for the house. When Karen number one, we are going to call her Joan now, and Sam, true owner of the house, went to talk with Karen, she at first denied everything. Then the police went with them. Karen screamed that she had the right to do that because she did a lot of things for this town. And nobody was to claim that house after all, so she did it and sold it. Sam reported her for property theft and Joan for the scam. Karen got fired from her work as a counselor and now she's being investigated. Sam and Joan agreed that he is going to sell the house to her. But they are going to ask in the trial that Karen pays Sam the money that Joan gave her for the house and the new papers for the property and compensation to both. Thanks for watching the video to the end. I hope you enjoyed it. Please let me know what you think about the stories and the video in general. Also, please don't forget to leave a like, comment and subscribe, and if you have time, watch another of my videos. And now, I hope you have a great day. See you soon. Bye bye.